contestants of the Miss World contest to be held next Tuesday. First of all, Miss Canada, how do you do?
How do you do?
I have a feeling you've been to this country before.
Yes, I have. I was born and brought up here, and I'm a new Canadian.
And you like Canada?
Very much. There's more space.
What do you particularly feel is needed to win a contest like this?
I have no idea. I haven't been in one exactly like this. In Canada, we have talent included in our scholarship program, as they call it. And I think it's just a... I used to kid and tell people that it was a matter of conning the judges.
Well, let's just move on. What is your ambition?
Oh, my ambition is to be a teacher.
What sort of things would you want to teach?
I would like to teach English and German, perhaps.
Now, supposing you win this contest, you might have the chance to become a film actress. Would you want to do this?
Oh, for a little time, but not for long, I think.
Well, can we turn now to Miss Burma? Miss Burma, you are a film actress in your own country.
Yes.
What sort of films do you like making?
Amusement.
Musical?
Yeah.
This is your first visit to London?
Yes, this is my first visit.
What is your main ambition?
My ambition is seen in opera.
Time I hear this sound. In London's Lyceum Ballroom, a fanfare for beauty. Gathered from the gardens of the world, these are the fairest blooms. Fair enough anyway to compete in the exciting last stages of the Miss World contest. For each lovely girl, personal ambition and national honor are at stake. For the judges, there's the delicate task of weighing the outstanding merits of one beauty against the perfections of another. Nice work if you can get it. And you can, here's your chance. Even if you've read the results, you can see if you think the judges were right. Miss Denise Muir, South Africa, came third. Miss Gila Golan, Israel, won second place. And among the final 10, Mrs. Hilda Fairclough, United Kingdom. The Lyceum, of course, was full of bird fanciers, including a Mouveterne ornithologist. The winner, she's Norma Capelli of Argentina, a 21-year-old brunette model from Buenos Aires. 36, 23, 36, if you must know. She gets 500 quid, a car, and a film test. When she arrived in London, her ambition, it said, was to see Hyde Park. Sorry, boys, she's seen it.
There were more figures than a chartered accountant could have coped with at the Lyceum. The loveliest creatures of 39 countries, all hoping to win the title Miss World. Some good judges of that sort of thing gave statistics their full attention, while the Parade of Beauty entertained an audience of 2,000. Beauty nourished in the United Kingdom, Hilda Fairclough of Heysham. From across the Atlantic came Judith Achter, a model only recently out of high school. A honey blonde from Dusseldorf is Miss Germany. She is Ingrid Mochtel, 5'10" of lissom beauty, a fashion model. Denise Muir, South Africa, third prize. And from Israel, Gila Jolan. She won second place. 21-year-old Norma Capelli, Miss Argentina, was the lucky winner of the title. At 21, the Buenos Aires brunette becomes Miss World, the sultry sensation of Latin America.